Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11th, Chapter 12th, Beyond Renunciation and Knowledge. Text number 3. Satsange nahi daiteya yatudhana mrugaha khagaha gandharvap saraso nagaha siddhascharana guyakaha. Satsange nahi daiteya yatudhana mrugaha khagaha gandharvap saraso nagaha siddhascharana guyakaha. Satsange nahi daiteya yatudhana mrugaha khagaha gandharvapsaraso nagaha siddhascharana guyakaha. Matajis? Satsange nahi daiteya word-to-word meaning, translation and purport. By the disciples of His Divine Grace, Abhay Charanarvinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Satsangena, by association with my devotees, he certainly, daiteyaha, the sons of Diti, yatudhanaha, demons, mrugaha, animals, khagaha, birds, gandharva, gandharvas, apsarasaha, the society girls of heaven, nagaha, snakes, siddhaha, residents of siddhalok, charana, the charanas, guyakaha, the guyakas. As such, this is a combination of four verses, so I am reading the translation for the whole. In every yuga, many living entities entangled in the modes of passion and ignorance gained the association of my devotees. Thus, such living entities as the daityas, rakshasas, birds, beasts, gandharvas, apsaras, nagas, siddhas, charanas, guyakas, and vidyadharas, as well as such lower class human beings as the vaishyas, shudras, women, and others, were able to achieve my supreme abode. Vritrasur, Prahlad Maharaj and others like them also achieved my abode by association with my devotees. As did personalities such as Vrishaparva, Bali Maharaj, Banasur, Maya, Vibhishan, Sugriv, Hanuman, Jambavan, Gajendra, Jatayu, Tuladhar, Dharmavyad, Kubja, the gopis in Vrindavan and the wives of the Brahmanans who were performing sacrifice. We are going to discuss two paragraphs of the purport out of the four paragraphs. Purport. The Lord has mentioned devotees such as the gopis in Vrindavan and also demons like Banasur to illustrate how he comes under the control of those who surrender to him. It is understood that devotees like the gopis and others mentioned here obtained pure love of Krishna, whereas the demons generally obtained only salvation. Many demons were purified by association with devotees and came to accept devotional service to the Lord as the most important among the various activities in their lives. But the exalted devotees like Prahlad and Bali Maharaj know nothing except devotional service, which they accept as their very life. Still, the reformed demons are also mentioned so that readers of Srimad Bhagavatam will understand the enormous benefits one may achieve by associating with devotees of the Lord. The demon Rudrasur was the pious king Chitraketu in his previous life, during which he associated with Sri Narad Muni, Sri Angira Muni and Lord Sankarshan. Prahlad Maharaj, being the son of Hiranyakashipu, is considered a daitya, a demon. Yet while still in the womb of his mother, Gayadhu, he associated with Narad Muni by sound vibration. The demon Rishaparva was abandoned by his mother at birth, but he was raised by a Muni and became a devotee of Lord Vishnu. Bali Maharaj associated with his grandfather Prahlad and also with Lord Vamandev. Bali Maharaj's son, Banasur, was saved by association with his father and Lord Shiva. He also associated with Lord Krishna personally when the Lord cut off all but two of his 1,000 arms, which had been awarded as a benediction by Lord Shiva. Understanding the glories of Lord Krishna, Banasur also became a great devotee. The demon Maya Danav constructed an assembly house for the Pandavas and also associated with Lord Krishna himself, eventually achieving the shelter of the Lord. Vibhishan was a pious-natured demon, the brother of Ravan, and he associated with Hanuman and Ramachandra. Om Jnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupaha Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Gurau Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamscha Namaha Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Nitinamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So we are discussing on this 12th chapter, Beyond Renunciation and Knowledge. Of this chapter, first 15 verses, they talk about Lord Krishna discloses supreme secret to his dear devotee Uddhav, and thereby he establishes the position of the gopis, which will come eventually. We are discussing 3rd to 6th verses, around 4 verses. First two verses talked about perfection comes by association of devotees. There Lord Krishna told Uddhav that what are the two benefits of association of devotees. The first is it destroys material attachment, and second, one attains Krishna, Krishna's supreme abode. And he talked there that this cannot be, Krishna cannot be obtained or cannot be achieved by Ashtanga Yoga, by taking sannyas, by many other personal, by many other practices. Krishna can be achieved only through association of devotees. In this particular 3rd to 6th verses, 4 verses, there are examples of those who achieved perfection. These are all very exalted devotees of the Lord. Just by taking their names itself is very purifying, as we heard them. So we may not be able to discuss all of them, but just in general we'll discuss some things in today's discussion. There are examples of Vritrasur, who earlier in his life was King Chitraketu, and how he got cursed by Mother Parvati and eventually became the demon Vritra. But therein his mentality of a pure devotee very nicely comes out in his fight with King Indra. In fact, Prabhupada says that devotionally Vritrasur was very glorious, whereas King Indra, he had to remain here only in this material world, to rot in this material world, because he wanted to continue to be in this world. So he remained here, whereas Vritrasura was very fortunate. He was only aspiring to go back to the spiritual world and join with the Lord and his devotees in the spiritual world. And also example of Prahlad Maharaj comes, how he got association of Narad Muni right from the quite before beginning. Once one devotee was telling that when Narad Muni visited the palace of Hiranyakashipu, he had a sword called Chandrahas, and he just chopped off Narad Muni's stomach. So whole sword crossed through the body of Narad Muni, and nothing was happening to Narad Muni. He was smiling very nicely. So Hiranyakashipu was wondering, so he looked at his sword. So sword had absolutely no tint of blood, and Narad Muni was smiling. So he asked him, Narad Muni told, "You want to know the secret?" And he said yes, because that was his goal, to never die. And here is a sage who is not dying by my chopping of his whole body. So he said, "Tapasya, austerities. So you can also perform austerities and be like me. You can conquer over death. Your body can be without any sling and all that." So that was the reason for Hiranyakashipu to go and perform austerities. When he went for performing austerities, all the demigods, they were all wondering. They were all very much tensed. So they approached Lord Brahma in Brahmalok and said, "This is very dangerous now. Please do something about this." So then Narad Muni and Parvat Muni, two friends, they volunteered. They said, "Okay, we will do something. Don't worry." So then they all went to the Parvat where this Hiranyakashipu was performing austerities. This comes in the Narasimha Puran. So both of them took the shape of two birds and they sat on one branch of one tree. And they started chanting, "Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya." So as Hiranyakashipu heard these words, he was wondering, who is this? How dare of this person to chant the name of my enemy in front of me only? So he opened his eyes and he looked around. So there in front of him only there was the tree, and there were two birds sitting and they were chanting. So he became very angry. Though he had gone to perform austerities, he had gone with bow and arrows. So he immediately bowed down and he picked up his bow and he set an arrow on it and he pulled the string to kill the two birds. As soon as they saw that, they both flew away and they started flying. And Hiranyakashipu was very angry. He went chasing after them. He went all the way, but then they disappeared. He was very angry. In that disturbed condition only, he came to his palace. And that is the time when he had association of his wife. And through that, the child Prahlad was born. So indirect Garbhadhan Sanskar was performed, because he was quite conscious of Vishnu. That Vishnu, what does he think of himself? I'll kill him. You know, how dare of him? Who are these two people? Must be his devotees only. So he's very disturbed. So this is Pratikul Garbhadhan, but anyway Garbhadhan Sanskar is done through the remembrance of Lord Vishnu. And that's why Prahlad was conceived. Then again, after some months, when Mother Kayadu was pregnant, the demigods headed by Indra, they thought this is the best time to kill this child in the womb of Hiranyakashipu, who is nothing but Hiranyakashipu's part and parcel, and going to be much bigger a demon than Hiranyakashipu is. So now, right now only is the best time to kill him. So they kidnap Mother Kayadu and they were dragging her to Devalok and were planning to do abortion. But again Narad Muni appeared there And he said, oh Indra, Chandra, Vayu, Varun, what are you doing? How can you do like this to a woman? That to a pregnant woman. This doesn't behave. So then they said, no, Devarshi Naraji, this woman is not anybody else but Hiranyakashipu's wife. And his child is in her womb. So we want to kill that child. That is the reason we are attacking. Then he explained to them, this child is not some demon, small or big, but rather he is a great devotee, Mahabhagavat, great devotee Prahlad. So don't think otherwise. So then they felt guilty of their wrong action. They paid obeisances to Mother Kayadu and circumambulated her whole body 3 times and they left for Devalok. Because she was carrying the greatest pure devotee of the Lord, Prahlad, in whose heart Lord always was residing. So that's why they considered her body to be temple. And temple has to be circumambulated. So 3 times they circumambulated and they left for Devalok. And then Narad Muni took her to his ashram and guided her in the Bhagavad Dharma. It was mainly for the child Prahlad because he was his disciple. In fact, I was seeing one clipping there. It was shown that Narad Muni was so absorbed in discussing Bhagavad Dharma that late night, daytime, afternoon, he was not understanding only because they are Trigunatit and also Trikalabadit. They are beyond the 3 modes and they are beyond the time also. So he was not realizing what is happening, but he was going on. It was maybe midnight or so. So Mother Kayadu, it was too much for her. She was already fearful that demigods may come and disturb me again. My child may be in threat, danger. And also, she was pregnant. She was tired of the whole day's services that she was rendering in the ashram. So she was feeling sleepy and she was drowsy. She was dozing. And when Narad Muni went on explaining Bhagavad Dharma, so there was the child in the womb. He was saying, And then another point, He is listening very attentively, everything with rapt attention. So that is Prahlad, and who heard. He did not see his guru, but he heard the Vani. So Prabhupada always said, Vapu and Vani, 2 associations of the spiritual master. Of that, Vani is very, very superior. That doesn't mean Vapu should be neglected. He did not have access to Vapu. He could not see his guru. But he saw his guru with his ears. And with such attentive hearing he did, that eventually he could repeat by verbatim to his friends in the Gurukul. And they were all surprised. They asked, where did you listen all this from? You know, we did not hear all this stuff. In this school it was never taught by Shanda and Amarga. And then he explained, this was all that I learned from my spiritual master, Narad Muni, when I was in the womb of my mother. So this is the caliber of Prahlad Maharaj. And he shows us how to take association very, very seriously. So this particular purport, translation as well as purport, and Krishna and Prabhupada disciples, they are focusing on association of devotees. So we'll discuss something about association, maybe some 3-4 points, importance of association, then Lord's love and protection for his devotees, what is association and what is not association, and how association elevates one to the supreme abode. In the Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter, 1st verse, Prabhupada in the purport says, one should always hear about the Lord in the association of devotees. That will enhance one's devotional service. So that though we have to perform chanting, but the chanting is best done in the association of devotees, never alone. Ekaki amar nahi paye bala hari nama sankirtane tumi kripa kari shraddha bindu diya deha krishna nama dhane. So ekaki amar, alone, I cannot practice chanting the holy name. We all have experience when we sit alone for chanting. It's very, very difficult. In fact, we face difficulty in the association of devotees also. But at least devotees are there to help us out. But alone, it's an impossibility. Somebody thinks he can make it alone. That's lunacy. That's madness. Prabhupada said that. So one should never become so overconfident that I can perform devotional service alone. No, it is best done in the association of devotees. Satam prasangan mama virya samvido bhavanti rutkarana rasayana kataha. In the association of devotees, like-minded devotees, sajatiya, like-minded, whose frequency is one. What is that frequency? We want to hear about Lord only. He is worth hearing about. Nobody else. There are so many subject matters. Srutavyadini Rajendra, Nrunam Santi Sahasrasha. But all those subject matters are about mundane topics. We want to talk, we want to hear about the Supreme Lord. So such kind of sajatiya, like-minded devotees, in their association when we hear, then it gives us such vitality. It gives life. Just like somebody who is very sick and has no energy in his body, if he is given some nice things, fluids for his body, through the saline and all. Then he gets a lot of power eventually through food and other stuff. Similarly, when we hear in the association of devotees, we get lot of strength, spiritual strength. And that strength can help us cross beyond all the obstacles that are posed by Maya in this material world, which is her area. Here nobody can win over Maya. Devi Esha Gunamai, Mama Maya Duratya. She is so powerful. She has two potencies, Avanatmika Shakti and Prakshapatmika Shakti. So these are very powerful potencies, Avanatmika Shakti. Whenever we are happy materially, basically she covers us over. And we feel such a nice world, such a nice place. I want to continue forever. So she increases our illusion and makes us continue in this material world. And then when there is dukkha, when there is unhappiness, then she is prakshapatmika. She is giving kicking potency. Kicking potency and covering potency. So our happiness, distress, all the dualities that we experience in this world is nothing but avanatmika shakti, covering potency, or prakshapatmika shakti, kicking potency. And thus Maya is very powerful. The whole world, you know, is filled with her potency only. So it's very difficult to overcome this. But Krishna says, Mamaivaya prapadyante mayam etam tarantite. But if one takes shelter of me, then one can easily cross beyond this material energy. In the book of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj, Ocean of Mercy, once he asked Prabhupada, so how does this work? So Prabhupada says there that in the association of devotees, the internal potency of the Lord is very powerfully active. So that's how one can overcome external potency. Otherwise impossible. That's why though we have to perform devotional service, we have to perform devotional service in the association of devotees, wherein internal potency is very much there. And she, when she is there is no question of then Bahiranga Shakti, because one Shakti only at a time, you know, either this or that. So that's why one should choose to be always in the association of devotees. In the Bhagavatam, fourth canto, 28th chapter, 26th verse, purport Prabhupada says, the association of devotees, Arya Sangama, is the most important factor in this world. Most important factor in this world. Prabhupada would wait for writing some words. Once one devotee in the morning walk asked Prabhupada, so is your translation going on? Prabhupada said, yes, but for last two and half days or so, I have not been able to get some word, so I am waiting for it. They said, Prabhupada, just put any word synonymous to the whole thing, to the whatever you want to say. Prabhupada said, no, I just can't put anything and everything. These are the law books for next 10,000 years. So Prabhupada has put his heart and soul in his books. And there he says, the association of devotees is the most important factor in this world. So what remains then? Most important. So that's why one should be very much eager to be in the association of devotees. There are so many verses all throughout in the Vedic literature, like Tulayama Lave Napi, Naswargam Na Punarbhavam, Bhagavad Bhakti Sangasya, Martyanam Ki Mutashasha. Now, even the Tulayam Lave Napi, and even the association for a moment of a devotee of the Lord cannot be compared to going to heaven. Though aspiration is there, you know, once Ravi Shankar was telling that we may not be aspiring for going to heaven, but actually many of us are aspiring to go to America. And some other places like Honolulu or wherever, very famous places in this world. So basically that is the same as, you know, aspiring to going to heaven, because we don't have much idea, clear idea about heaven, so we may not be aspiring so much. But actually all these ideas or desires to go to America and all, this is same as going to planning desire to go to heaven. So this cannot be compared to going to heaven, cannot be compared to merging in Brahma Jyoti, where one experiences so much of peace. But no, Tulyam Lavenapi na Swargam na Punarbhavam, Bhagavat Bhakti Sangasya, Martyanam Kim Utashisha. What could be better benediction for the mundane mortals, especially the devotees of the Lord? The devotees of the Lord, their association is the best. Lord Shiva says, Aradhananam Sarvesham, Vishnu Aradhanam Param, Tasmat Parataram Devi, Tadiyanam Samarchanam. Of all the worships, the best is worship of Vishnu. And better than worship of Vishnu is the worship of Tadiya, the things related to the Lord. And the topmost thing related to the Lord are His devotees. So that's why association of devotees should be sought after. In Bhagavatam only He says, Mag Bhakta Puja Bhidikaha. Better than my worship is worshipping my devotees. So we worship the Lord with so many articles, you know, according to Pancharatrika Vidhi and also according to Bhagavat Vidhi. But the better than that is worshipping His devotees. In Bhagavatam only He says, Acharya Mam Vijaniyam Na Avamanneta Karichit. know the acharya to be myself. The acharya, at the time of initiation, the disciple surrenders his life to the lotus feet of his spiritual master. Diksha kale shishya kare atma samarpan, sahi kale krishna tare kare atma sam. That time Krishna is ready to give the position of the same level as himself to the such a surrendered disciple. It depends on how much he surrenders at the time of initiation or at the earliest. His Grace Kaunteya Prabhu was telling that some people get initiated before initiation, some people get initiated during initiation, and some people get initiated after initiation, and some people kind of never get initiated. That means internal initiation, giving one's whole existence at the lotus feet in the service of the spiritual master, that is the real initiation. So that may happen for few much before the external ceremony of initiation, for some during the ceremony, for some after the ceremony later on, or for some maybe never kind of, because they did not give their heart to their spiritual master. So knowing the acharya to be oneself, then the famous shloka in Chaitanya Charitamrita, sadhu sangha sarva shastraikai, lava matra sadhu sanghe sarva siddhi hoy. The association of devotees, again is saying sadhu sangha, sarva shastraikai. All the scriptures talk about sadhu sangha. In fact, Prabhupada says our ISKCON is meant for this only, to give people association of those who have not forgotten Krishna. In one sense, Prabhupada was the only one who did not forget Krishna, but he created a wave of devotion in the hearts of so many of his followers, and they are eventually creating, you know, giving that wave to others also. Prabhupada said, you know, my spiritual master pushed me and I am pushing you, and you push the rest of the world. Push means not just physically push and artificially forcefully push, but basically inspire people to chant Hare Krishna. Prabhupada was asked, Prabhupada himself asked his disciples, so why did I write my books? And some disciples said, Prabhupada for distribution. Prabhupada said no. And then somebody said, Prabhupada for your disciples to get engagement. Prabhupada said no. And again, so many answers, but Prabhupada said no. I have written these books to inspire everyone to chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So anybody who reads Srila Prabhupada books will be inspired to chant Hare Krishna. Anybody finds, any devotee finds, I am not able to chant Hare Krishna properly, that means there is some deficiency in our reading of Srila Prabhupada book. So one can read again, you know, with respect. Respect. Again, with respect one should read Prabhupada books. So sadhu sangha is very, very important thing, and by moments association of sadhu, you know, sarva siddhi hove, all perfection will be reached. What will be the perfection? One will receive Krishna. Krishna se tomar, Krishna dite paro, tomara shakati ache. Krishna is the possessed property of the pure devotee. And the pure devotee offers Krishna to everyone through his association. Once Narad Muni had this question. He had heard so many glories of sadhu sangha, association of devotees are described all throughout the scriptures. What is the power of associating with a sadhu for some moment, one moment or so? So he went to Vaikuntha and asked Lord Narayan, my dear Lord, could you please tell me what is the power of associating with a sadhu for a moment? He said, go to earth, there that pond is there, and that particular fish, you ask the fish. And he was wondering, Lord, could I answer directly? Why is he directing me to some fish? Okay, anyway, he came to earth and he went to that pond and asked that fish there. There are many fishes, one particular fish. My dear fish, could you please let me know what is the power of associating with a devotee for a moment? And the fish's eyes wide open, he on the spot died. And Narad Muni felt bad. Oh my God, I don't know. Maybe the question was too heavy or what. You know, maybe I should not ask. But then again, he was disturbed. He went back to Vaikuntha world and asked, oh Lord Narayan, that fish died only after I asked him this question. So could you please, you only answer the directly question. You know, very simple question. So he said, no, now you go to earth and there in the forest meet the deer, one deer. Now meet and ask that deer. So again Narad Muni came to earth and went to forest and asked, my dear deer, could you please let me know that what is the association, what is the power of associating with one devotee for a moment? And the deer's eyes became wide open and deer collapsed on the ground, died on the spot. Narad Muni is such a compassionate devotee, Jiva Himsan, this is to be avoided, and pure devotees never want to hurt anyone, and here is the death of two living entities by now. So he felt very bad. So then again he went to Vaikuntha and asked, Lord, now this deer died, I don't know what is this question, And what is the answer? You know, please now you only tell. He said, no, you go to again on earth only, and there is calf is there. He said, oh Lord, no. Now what if calf dies? You know, that will be too much. Go hatya. He said, no, just go and ask. So then again he went to earth and on that one particular goshala, and there he asked that calf, my dear calf, please tell me what is the power of associating with a devotee for a moment. And the calf's eyes became wide open and he fainted on the ground, died on the spot. Now Narad Muni was completely disturbed. My God, and, go hatya, too much. So again he went and he was almost pleading, oh Lord, please forgive me. I don't know whether there is some offense or what in my question that, you know, all these things are happening. Now you only please answer. He said, no, now you go to one human child there, just born, baby. He said, my God, now this will be human hatya, you know, killing. He said, no, just go and ask him. So now fourth time Narad Muni came to earth and asked that child, small baby, that my dear child, could you please let me know what is the power of associating with a devotee for a moment? And he said, this is it. He said, what is it? This is it. What is it? This is it, my dear Narad Muni. You know, you see, I was that fish in the pond and you came and gave moments association. I was elevated to deer's body. There also you very came very mercifully and you gave your association. I was elevated to calf's body, cow's body, just a birth before human birth. And there also you mercifully came and awarded your association. And then I am elevated to human birth. This is most suitable for perfecting one's life to by taking to spiritual life. So I am so fortunate by your association. That this is the glory that I got association of a saint like you for a moment and this elevated me to such a high level. You know? So very grateful to you. And Narad Muni felt embarrassed because that was his own glorification. And he got the answer. So you can see that Sadhu Sangha is very, very powerful. So now we'll discuss how Lord's love and protection is there for his devotees. All throughout Vedic literature he speaks that. Ananyaschintayanto mam yejana paryupasate tesham nitya bhiyuktanam yogakshema vahamyaham. So he says those who are undividedly, with undivided attention, they are thinking of me, Krishna says. For them, I provide what they lack and I preserve what they have. And so this is Krishna's promise. For his devotees, he'll provide everything. Everything material also, devotees need not worry. That doesn't mean that they should be lazy and not do their worldly responsibilities. But the point is, if their attention is always focused on Krishna, Krishnarthi Akhila Chesta, all my endeavors, my mind should be contemplating on Krishna, my words should be speaking about and glorifying Krishna, and my body should be as much as possible, directly or indirectly, engaged in the service of the Lord. So for such devotees, Krishna provides everything. Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam dhadami buddhi yogam tam yenamam upayantite. So Krishna is qualifying two things here, quantity and quality. Tesham satata yuktanam, as far as quantity, satat 24/7, and quality, bhajatam priti purvakam, with love. What is important is love. Krishna is hungry for our love because we are his children. What can we provide him in return to him? Nothing is there which could be pleasing him than love and devotion. So for such devotees, Krishna says, I give them intelligence by which they can come to me. Tesham evanu kamparatham aham agyana jam tamaha nashayami atma bhavastu jnana deepena bhasvataha. For such completely continuously dedicated devotees who are always engaged in Krishna's activities, for such people Krishna says, you know, in their heart, you know, dwelling as super soul, I remove their darkness of ignorance, you know, by torchlight of knowledge. So Krishna gives all help for his devotees. In Brahma Vaivarta Puran, there is one shloka which says, Dhyayante Vaishnava Shashvat Govinda Pada Pankajam Dhyayate Tamsha Govinda Shashvate Shamcha Sannidhau. He says, Dhyayante Vaishnava Shashvat. Vaishnavas are always thinking of the Supreme Lord. Govinda Pada Pankajam. In their mind, they always have the lotus feet of Lord Govinda. And what is Krishna doing in return? Dhyayate Tamscha Govinda. And in his return, Krishna is also doing dhyana of his devotees. But one special extra quality with Krishna, Shashvat Teshamcha Sannido. By being next to his devotees. He's there next to his devotees. In fact, devotee himself may not be able to see with the gross eyes, but he is there always. That is his promise. For those devotees who are always thinking of his lotus feet. Next shloka he says, Sudarshanam sanniyojya bhaktanam rakshanaya cha tathapi nahi nischinto avatishtheta bhakta sannido. He says, Sudarshanam sanniyojya. I have appointed Sudarshan. For what? Bhaktanam rakshanaya cha. For the protection of my devotees. But he says, tathapi nahi nischinto. But still I am not carefree. Why are you not carefree? Because the devotee's problem is, devotees are very compassionate. They can forgive even the person who attacks on the devotee himself. The best example is our Namacharya Haridas Thakur. He was attacked by those two executioners. They beat him through 22 marketplaces. But when Sudarshan was released by the Lord from Vaikuntha, and Sudarshan came there, and Namacharya Haridas Thakur said, "Oh my dear Lord, please, they have no offense towards me. They have not offended me at all. They have no personal enmity with me. It was the king and Qazi who had something. Basically, they don't even know me properly. You know, please don't punish them. They have no fault." So the Sudarshan was going with such a high speed there, ready to act, but he is rendered helpless there because of the compassion of Haridas Thakur. That's why he says, "Tathapi nahi nischinto." That's why I am not carefree. And what do I do? Avatishtheta bhakta sannidho. I stay next to my devotee only. Why? Because Sudarshan sometimes may fail. Sudarshan never fails, but the compassion of devotees defeats Sudarshan's power. In this case, like we are saying in the case of Namacharya Haridas Thakur. So then what happened? Did Haridas Thakur end? No. You know, because he says, Kaunteya pratijani name bhakta pranashati. My devotee never perishes. Then what? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally appeared, though externally he had not appeared in this world, but invisibly he appeared there, and with his own body, he covered the body of Haridas Thakur and took all the beatings on his own back. And that he revealed quite later, eventually in Mahaprakash Leela, to Haridas Thakur. He said, "Haridas, you know, that time you were not ready to take help, though I wanted to help you through Sudarshan. So then I had to personally come and cover your body. And you see now." And when he saw the beatings marks on the Lord's back, Haridas at once fainted on the ground. "Oh Lord, I don't deserve this." So this is the humility of the Vaishnavas, that they don't feel that they are qualified. So this kind of love exists between the Lord and his pure devotees. Again to Durvasa Muni, Lord Narayan in Vaikuntha said, "Sadhavo rudayam mayam sadhunam rudayam tuham madanyatena jananti naham tebhyo managapi." Sadhus are always in my heart. By the way, sadhu is not the one who wears saffron dress and shaved head and all that necessarily. Could be. But more important is, sadhu is one who has given his heart to Krishna. So anybody who has given his heart to Krishna, that includes mind, that includes body, that includes words. You know, anybody who has given that, he is a sadhu. Because we find externally, Amrish Maharaj was not a renunciant. You know, he was a grihastha, he was a king with so many worldly responsibilities, but he was a sadhu in the true sense. So that's why sadhavo rudhayam mayam. Sadhus are always in my heart, Lord Narayan is saying to Durvasa. And sadhunam rudhayam tuham. And I am in the hearts of my sadhus. They don't know anyone but me, and I don't know anyone but them. So as we are trying to be Krishna conscious here on this planet Earth, Krishna is already devotee conscious. We find in the pastime of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when that Brahmin boy visited his house, he found Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chanting, "Gopi, Gopi, Gopi." So what is that? Gopi is the devotee's name. So many devotees. So Lord is remembering. Lord is chanting their name. Also in Sri Brihad Bhagavatamrut, and there is a revelation by Sanatana Goswami that how the queens of Dwarka, they were saying that in the night Krishna is all the time chanting the names of his devotees only. Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Mai, and different gopis. So Krishna is always devotee conscious. And devotees, the best devotees are always, they are always conscious of Krishna. There is a statement, Prabhupada says, devotees of the Lord are more merciful or more powerful than the Lord by the mercy of the Lord. So Lord empowers his devotees. Just like any ordinary father also, it is seen that whatever education he has acquired, he wants his son to be more educated than himself. He wants his son to be better placed as far as financial status or even social status is concerned. Just like father has done B.Tech, he wants his son to be at least M.Tech or PhD or postdoc, like that. So similarly, Krishna is like that. You know, where is this nature in the living entity coming from in any ordinary father? That's coming from Krishna. Krishna wants to elevate his devotee more than himself also. In the Bhagavad Gita, he says to Arjun, "In the form of time, I have killed all these warriors here. But nimitta matram bhava savya sachin. You just become an instrument. You know, I want to give you the credit." So Krishna wants to give credit to his devotees. That is his greatness. Why? Because devotees always want to give credit to Krishna. So this is reciprocal. So now discussing about what is and what is not association. In the different places it is said that association is not just physical proximity. Association is where there is involvement of love, where there is attachment and where there is attraction. Otherwise, if not this thing, then in the Bombay locals, and everybody will be heavily, every devotee will be heavily getting influenced by that association. The physical proximity doesn't matter. What matters is where is our heart. We are where our mind is. So what are the contemplations of the mind? That is very, very important. So love, attachment and attraction, these are very important. In the fourth verse of Sri Upadeshamrut, Srila Rupa Goswami Pat tells us, Dadati Pratigrahanati, Guhyam Akhyati Prushyati, Bhungte Bhojayate Chaiva, Shadvidam Priti Lakshanam. The four symptoms of love shared between one devotee and other. Another are giving of gifts and accepting of gifts. Then revealing one's mind in confidence and hearing others' mind in confidence when they do that. And offering prasadam and accepting prasadam. So these are the six exchanges of love. Basically all these, and if we see, these are social interactions. But when the devotees do, in the devotees' interactions, there is Krishna there. When they give gifts related to Krishna. That's how we have an entire gift shop. So many varieties of items are there, you know, which are related to Krishna. So devotees keep giving to one another these gifts for some occasion, some whatever reason. And then also they give prasadam, which is offered to Krishna. And their hearts they reveal. What is there in the heart? Ecstasy basically. Sometimes it is understood to be problems. Just approach some senior and keep telling, load him with the problems, and then he will tell, I have bigger problems than you do. So this is not so much said. Actually, this is basically machitta madgata prana bodhayanta parasparam. And the devotees meet, they tell, you know, I had been having association of such and such devotee, and you know what he said, this is what he said, and it was such an enlivening point. I was so much, you know, so much touched by this. And this devotee also shares, oh Prabhu, I also associated with this devotee and he told me this point. So this is actually sharing of hearts. This is the real meaning. But when we don't do this enough, then there will be so many problems and then keep discussing the problems only. So that's not what devotee community should be about. You know, when there are problems which are even inevitable in this world, we may discuss. But the greatest problem in this world is lack of Krishna consciousness, as Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told Srila Prabhupada. And if that, the only solution for that is Krishna consciousness. And Prabhupada was told that you just take this whole message of Guru Parampara and distribute to everyone. That will do good to you and it will do good to all those who come in touch with you. And Prabhupada took those words very seriously, and that's how we are all getting benefited now. He got benefited, but more than him, we are getting benefited now. Because of that serious instruction that he took very, very seriously. And there we find only two instructions Prabhupada got. First, in 1922, you are a young educated man, why don't you preach the message of Lord Chaitanya in English language all over the world? He took it so seriously and his whole focus was on that. And in 1936, October, in the Kartik Yatra, Vrajamandal Parikrama of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, just before his physical departure, he again gave the second instruction that whenever you get money, print books. So as reciprocation with these two instructions, we find Prabhupada established two organizations. For the first instruction, he has ISKCON, and for the fulfillment of the second instruction, he has BBT. So through this, Prabhupada covered the whole thing, entire instruction of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And so much he benefited us through all this activity. So that's why Prabhupada's mind was always in Bhakti, in the Lilamrit. It is written by Srila Satsrudas Goswami Maharaj that when he received the second instruction on the bank of Radhakund in 1936, these words of his spiritual master kept ringing in the mind of Abhay Charanarvinda Das. You know, whenever you get money, print books. Whenever you get money, print books. Whenever you get money, print books. This only kept ringing, not just on the bank of Radhakund for that moment, all throughout his life. And he gave his every blood particle, blood and sweat, whole existence for fulfilling these two instructions of his spiritual master, and created such wonderful opportunity for the entire world for all time to come. So this is the power of association. Prabhupada took association of Bhaktivinoda Thakur very seriously, you know, and then he offered it to all of us and empowered us. So we can see Prabhupada always, though he was a grihastha, he was having his pharmaceutical industry and so many things, but he was always contemplating how to fulfill the instruction of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So that's what it shows. This is association. His love was for his guru, for his books, the message that he gave there. And for that he dedicated his life. He was attached to that only. So many people instructed him in so many different ways. If that was not in line with Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur's instruction, he did not worry too much about it. But anybody who said anything in connection with that, he took it very seriously. Just like that postman who said, Swamiji, why do you print these magazines? Magazines people won't take so seriously. Books people revere a lot. So that would be better. And Prabhupada said, this is my spiritual master speaking through this postman. Now apparently that postman was doubtful whether he was chanting one round also or not. But Prabhupada never said he is a zero rounder. Prabhupada said, this is my spiritual master speaking through him. So he took it very seriously. So what is our contemplation? That is very important. That's what is our association. In the book Devotee Care, His Holiness Niranjan Swami Maharaj writes that it is not just out of duty that we do something, some association. That is called as association. But basically, you know, it has to be love, with love. In the Jaiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also says, it is not just some, you know, external social interactions. It has to be the involvement of love. In the Devotee Care book, Niranjan Maharaj gives the example of beggar. Somebody may give some donation to the beggar, but there is no hearty involvement there. Just a duty, okay, poor fellow, you know, let me give him something. So it is not so much love there. Similarly, we may accept donation from somebody, so it is not so much love there, it's just a duty. On behalf of the Lord, we accept it. So this is not what is association. Association means where there is love, where there is attachment, where there is attraction. In the Jaiva Dharma, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur talks why the devotees find difficulty in progressing, though they have such association of other devotees. So he talks about two terms, Dveshi Sangha and Sadhu Sangha. So there is association of envious people and there is association of devotees. So whose association we take seriously? If there is overall association of dveshis, those who are envious of the Lord and the whole process of devotional service, if their association is taken more, not necessarily externally but internally, basically where there is love, where there is attachment and attraction, that's what is association. So if one is very much doing that of the dveshi sangha, then basically one cannot progress smoothly. And when there is sadhu sangha exceeding the dveshi sangha, then one makes progress. So this tug of war will always be there. Maya will offer dveshi sangha unlimitedly. And Krishna will offer unlimitedly sadhu sangha also. And it depends on every individual, his free will, his choice, whom does he choose. It is there at every moment. Every moment is moment for surrendering to Krishna or Maya. That is individual's choice. But based on the association that we have taken, one has the power to discriminate properly, and then accordingly one may choose a particular thing. So there are many statements about this associating with sadhus. In the Jaiva Dharma, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur talks about, gives very nice explanation of the shloka, which is famous, Prabhupada quotes many times in his book. Yasyatma buddhi kunapetri dhatuke swadhi kalatra adishu bhauma ijjati yattirtha buddhi salilena karichit janeshu abhigneshu saeva gokaraha. So we have heard meaning in the bodily terms, you know, yasyatma buddhi, atma buddhi, one who thinks his body made up of kapha, vata, pitta, these three elements, to be himself, that is atma buddhi. Kunapetri dhatuke swadhi, you know, then the things related to his body, the land where he is born, and his before that kalatradishu, his wife, his children, they be his own. Mamata buddhi is there towards them. Then tirtha buddhi, before that bhauma ijjati, the land of his birth to be worshipable. We were taught from childhood, janani janma bhumi swargadapi gariyase, one's own mother and motherland, Bharat Mata, motherland, you know, is more worshipable than swarga also. And we were in the patriotic zone, we were thinking like that. But here it is said that, you know, this is ijja buddhi, so this is also condemned. And beyond that, tirtha buddhi, to think that some place which is considered a holy place, to go and take a dip there in the holy water, that is the perfection of life, and I get rid of all my sins and then I can do any further sin then. So this kind of mentality will not help. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains four buddhis all related to devotee sangha. So he says atma buddhi. There it is condemned, but here he says now atma buddhi, to think that I am the servant of devotees. This kind of understanding is very, very helpful. This is atma buddhi, positive atma buddhi. Then mamata buddhi. So mamata buddhi means devotees are mine and I am devotees. I am the sole property of devotees and my only property is devotees. You know, I don't have anything in life but devotees. You know, if they give me up, I have no hope. I cannot. With all the things of this world, I have no hope in this world. So this kind of mamata buddhi has to develop. Then eventually ijja buddhi, worshipable. Devotees are worshipable. You know, so how many devotees are there in my heart? I can take agarbatti, I can take incense stick and do their aarti 7 times around their whole body. Then ghilam, 4 times to their lotus feet, 2 times to their lotus navel, and 3 times to their lotus face, and 7 times to the entire body. How many devotees I can worship with all those articles with which we worship the Supreme Lord? So this is ijja buddhi. We do that certainly for Prabhupada and many of his great followers. But eventually as we develop, we should be able to accommodate, should be able to worship more and more and more number of devotees. And then eventually the last is tirtha buddhi. The devotees are holy places personified themselves. As Yudhishthira Maharaj told Vidurji, who went for entire parikrama, he went all over India, holy places. And when he came back, he said, Bhavadvida Bhagavata Tirtha Bhuta Swayam Vibho Tirthi Guruvanti Tirthani Swa Antasthena Gadabhrutaha. The personality is like your good self. Bhavadvida Bhagavatas Tirtha Bhuta Swayam Vibho. You are the holy place personified for me. By seeing a devotee, one gets the benefit of associating or going visiting all the holy places. At the lotus feet of the spiritual master, all the holy places are residing. One need not go here and there and keep wandering and keep seeing. That will be just a sightseeing, which was very much condemned by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And Prabhupada is the best example. When Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur was speaking for long and Kosikala place, and then it was evening, there was announcement that devotees have second option now. There is nearby Shishishai Vishnu temple. Those who wish could go and have darshan. At once, thousands of them got up and left. Only 12-15 remained. Those who were very close, confidential associate. Maybe somebody who was sound system in charge, he might have been there. But apart from that, only odd man out in the whole crowd was one devotee in white, you know, with hair. And that was Abhay Charanarvinda Das. You know, he was the only grahastha who was a bit odd looking there. Why did he not go? He said, what will I see with these fleshy eyeballs, with the charma chakshu? What can I understand the Lord? The real darshan is when I hear from the lotus leaves of my spiritual master. Then I will be able to understand the Lord. In the Kardamuni and Swayambhumano discussion, in the purport, Prabhupada says, the only organ, the only way to receive the favor of the spiritual master is through the ears. Only organ to receive the favor of the spiritual master is through ears. You know, because one who hears his spiritual master and his representatives very seriously, such a person is really associating, and he will do that very nicely, as we see in the case of Prabhupada. So devotees are holy places personified themselves, Swantasthena Gadabhruta, because they are carrying Krishna in their heart. So association of such devotees should be sought after. We have example of Mrugari, who associated with Narad Muni, Ratnakar, who eventually became Valmiki Muni. These all, even Kaliya, who associated with his wives, who were great devotees of Krishna. Eventually he realized that I have to take shelter of Krishna when the poison was out. So this poison has to go out, the anarthas and all the other things. Then we will take association of devotees very, very seriously. But what to do till then, when the anarthas are there? Till then also continue to be in the association of devotees and keep hearing, keep reciprocating with their love and devotion that they offer through the message, transcendental message, and one will make lot of progress. There cannot be that much progress made in millions of lifetimes than what could be done in the association of devotee for just few moments. In one particular scripture it is said, Jivitam Vishnu Bhaktasya Varam Pancha Dinani Cha Natukalpa Sahastrani Bhakti Hinasya Keshave. A devotee staying for 5 days in the material world is much more beneficial than any bhakti-heen, anybody who does not have bhakti, staying for hundreds of eons, hundreds of millenniums, somebody may be staying, but that is not as much helpful, beneficial to the whole world, as much as a devotee, pure devotee of the Lord, staying on the planet Earth just for 5 days. So how important is the association of devotees? In fact, this is unlimited subject matter. Prabhupada discusses all throughout his books so nicely. So, and in the association of devotees, we experience this. What is the power? Personally, we are powerless, but in the association of devotees, we become very powerful. So this should be the understanding, and that is the understanding given through this particular verse by Lord Krishna to Uddhav. He is citing the examples of so many great personalities, very worshipable personalities. And each one of them, in their background, we find that they had association of devotees. So thank you all very much. Hare Krishna. Any question? Time is over almost. Okay. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Samaveta Gaura Bhaktavrinda ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanandi.